Today we're going to be taking a look at 9 of the most hated skateboarders.
Now, right off the bat, let me just say, I'm not saying that I personally hate these skaters, but rather just at one point or another, for whatever reason, these people have garnered their own fair share of hate in the skateboarding community. Up first, we have Ryan Scheckler. Ryan Scheckler started skating at a really young age, and he was getting really good really fast. And to capitalize on a young up-and-comer who was transitioning into adulthood and had plenty of crowd appeal, MTV gave him his own reality show called The Life of Ryan. After this, at best, most skaters saw him as a whiny teenager, while others considered him to have already sold out at such a young age. But regardless, the show ended and he went back to strictly skateboarding, and a few years later is where the next reason for people to dislike him arose. During an interview with Thrasher's Jake Phelps, he claimed to have landed what would have been an extremely impressive trick down El Toro.
This is what I heard, that you backside flipped El Toro, yes or no?
Yes.
But a few years later, when the video came out, everyone was either saddened or angry to see that this in fact was not the case. Either way, there's no denying that Ryan Scheckler is an extremely talented skater. Up next, we have Mark Rogowski, better known as Gator. Gator was a professional skateboarder in the late 80s to early 90s. He was pretty crazy, but he was also very talented for the time. After the huge popularity of vert skating started to dwindle, Gator saw a loss in both money and prominence. It was a few years after this, and following a breakup with his girlfriend, that Gator ended up finally snapping, and he ended up murdering one of his ex-girlfriend's friends along with some other pretty horrific acts. Shortly after this, Gator turned himself in and he's been in prison ever since. And if you want to know more about this, I suggest you watch the documentary called Stoked for a pretty good overview of his life. At number 3, we have Ollie Bulala. Ollie was an extremely talented and unique skater who skated for Flip Skateboards, but was also good friends with the Baker Boys. He was known for pushing the limits of skateboarding, not only with big obstacles, but with his interesting take on it too. And during the peak of his career, there was another up-and-coming prodigy called Shane Cross, who was an amazing skateboarder with great style and was pretty much all around loved. One night while they were partying, Ollie Bulala decided to take his motorcycle out on a ride, and Shane Cross made the unfortunate decision to jump on the back, and shortly after, due to excess speeds and alcohol, Ollie ended up crashing his motorcycle, injuring himself, and sadly killing Shane Cross. There's a good epically latered about Ollie Bulala, which talks about before and after the crash, and needless to say, it was a really sad event, so it was easy for people to both sympathize with him and hate him. Up next, we have Jeremy Rogers. Jeremy Rogers was another skateboarder who saw success at a young age. After becoming really good and really popular, Jeremy got on DVS shoes and girl skateboards and was making an insane amount of money a month. And then seemingly out of the blue, he quit skateboarding to become a rapper. Now, I've never actually heard his music, so I can't tell you whether or not he's a good rapper, but the sudden shift definitely threw a lot of people off. And along with his newfound career, came changes in his appearance and behavior, which led more than a few people to wonder what happened. It does seem over the last few years that he has been making an entry back into skateboarding, but his goofy mannerisms still persist.
That worked.
Coming up next, we have Corey Kennedy. After getting some recognition for winning an old contest on the barracks, Corey Kennedy's career seemed to take off. After a few years of awesome video parts, he eventually became pro for girl skateboards. On August 31st, 2017, in a story that unfolded, unfortunately, a lot like Ollie Bulala's, Corey Kennedy was driving a car while intoxicated, and beloved skateboard filmer Preston Majetter, also known as P-Stone, was in the passenger seat. This ended up with Corey Kennedy crashing the car and P-Stone unfortunately losing his life. This led to Corey Kennedy being charged with vehicular homicide and getting dropped from some of his sponsors. This incident left a lot of people angry at Corey Kennedy and the situation in general. Corey did maintain some of his sponsors, and he's supposedly working on a new video part. For number 7, we have Rob Dyrdek. Now, if you were born after a certain year, you may not even know that Rob Dyrdek was once a prominent pro skateboarder. Riding for Alien Workshop in DC, he put out several awesome video parts. But it wasn't until the DC video premiered in 2003, which featured a skit with him and Christopher Boykin, also known as Big Black, that Rob's fame started to expand outside of the skateboarding world. starting off with a show on MTV called Robin Big, and then eventually moving to the Fantasy Factory and then Ridiculousness, Rob Dyrdek became the epitome of what most skaters would call a sellout. And on top of that, he started the skateboard competition, Street League, which was loved by many, but the other half of core skateboarders just saw this as another way for him to capitalize on making skateboarding mainstream. Regardless of what you think of him, it's hard to say that he's not a good businessman, and he has done his fair share to give back to the skateboarding world. Coming up, we have Steve Barra. Steve Barra is another pro skater who was really popular in the late 90s to mid 2000s. And alongside Eric Costin, he's one of the founders of The Barracks. The first of his controversies started when he put out a skate part that included some fake skate spots. Now, I'm not going to go into depth on what I mean by fake skate spots, but I'll put a link over to Rad Rat's channel where he covered this topic in depth. But besides that, it seems like the main criticisms people have of Steve Barra are his interactions on social media. Whether it be posting a video ranting about a company's questionable business moves, and then going and selling half of his company to Hypebeast, or calling out YouTube skaters on social media, while also having a Barracks YouTube channel at the same time. It seems like every few weeks now that you see Steve Barra on Instagram, in some sort of argument with other skaters, other brands, or just anyone in general. Either way, the end was an awesome skate video. Up next, we have Bam Margera. Just like Ryan Scheckler and Rob Dyrdek, Bam Margera was an awesome skateboarder first who had some good video parts, and then eventually ended up in the reality star business. Carrying on his antics from videos like CKY and CKY2K, he ended up as part of the Jackass crew, and then eventually scored a handful of his own reality shows. Eventually, this led to him becoming an alcoholic and quitting skateboarding. And at this point, while many people enjoyed his antics, he was seen by a good handful of the skate community as a sellout. Thankfully, within the last year or so, it seems like he's turning his life around, and he started to get back into skateboarding and filming. So hopefully we start seeing some new footage. And last but not least, we have Nyjah Houston. Nyjah started skating when he was 4 years old, and he's been incredibly talented ever since. Not only has he put out some of the craziest skateboard parts in recent history, but he's also earned countless medals and money in skateboard competitions, which unsurprisingly has led him to a life of expensive cars, big houses, and partying. When it comes to Nyjah, it seems like the two reasons people dislike him are that when it comes to skateboarding, it seems like his mindset is more like that of a jock. Street League is an example where it seems like he's only there for the money rather than having fun. And on the other side of things, people seem to dislike him because he's young and rich and sometimes acts like an entitled celebrity rather than a skater. Either way though, whether you like him or you hate him, there's no denying that he is one of the most talented skateboarders. So this was just a little list of skateboarders, past and present, who have had their fair share of hate, whether deserved or not. And I'm curious to know, is there anyone you think doesn't deserve to be on this list? And if so, then who would you replace them with? And once again, I know I said it in the beginning, but people are somehow going to ignore that one and this one. But this wasn't a video of skaters that I hate, but just skaters who I've seen other handfuls of people hate on in the past. Like always, I'd like to thank my Patreon pledgers. Keep keeping it real, and thank you. And besides that, I'd like to thank you for watching, and you can like and subscribe if you want.